that's not a theme. Upcoming board meetings, March 13, 2017, regular meeting, Tempanoo Valley High School at 7 p.m. April 17, 2017, regular meeting, Mentone Elementary at 7 o'clock. And May 8, 2017, regular meeting, Akron Elementary at 7 o'clock. With that being said, we will move on to B, spotlight on the ballot.
Okay, thank you. I think I see a new employee in the audience tonight, Andrew Murphy. Andrew, you will be approved tonight, hopefully by the school board, for a position as instructional assistant at Akron. So where are you working at down there, Andrew?
I'm working with the board of directors at Akron.
Enjoy that?
I do.
Andrew, you graduated from Tempanoo Valley in?
2008.
What have you been doing since then?
I went to school in the future, graduated December, California, bachelor's degree in education. I'm licensed to be a director.
What's your area of study in education?
Elementary education, I have a degree in students.
Okay, so you're looking to become an elementary teacher?
Yes.
So your teaching is finished?
Yes, I have finished that last semester, I was at Pearson Elementary.
Anything else you'd like to share with us, Andrew? Okay, welcome, glad you're here. Thank you, Andrew. Yeah, might be a good idea to have Officer Q, why don't you introduce yourself to these folks, Officer Q, and perhaps if you want to introduce your wife there.
Hello, I'm Dr. Q, I'm the sheriff's department, I'm a school resource officer. I'm in Allison, it's like a great position with a medical, kind of medical town marshal.
Is my wife Donna?
And there's a police officer, right? I'm a sheriff for around 25 years. It's time to pick it up.
So now in addition to being the resource officer out here, you'll be our DARE officer as well, right?
Yes.
So have you started in Akron, Mentone, yet, DARE?
Akron, Mentone, we think, by the officer that just left.
Oh, yeah.
I'm also responsible for a couple schools, a regular school district, and three or four schools in the ball system. And by the end of the contract, I'm going to set the program. I'll start here for the Valley, the plus council. I just went out visiting fifth grade classes, and there was another Saturday, so I went to school. It was a national class, it was a few classes.
And you were here a few years ago, how long ago was that, that you were SRO?
A few years ago.
And you're just?
2000.
Okay.
Better years.
Glad you're here, welcome.
Celebration of 2016 TVMS success highlights.
All right, I'm going to just bring the screen over to you guys a little bit. Since you only come to my building one time a year, I'm going to take some time here and show you guys some of the things that have gone very well for our school during this particular school year. So I want to start off with some school culture items. First off, in September, we received the Title I grant for $10,000. Our teachers were allowed to apply for classroom instructional needs. So that $10,000 was guaranteed to the middle school. Our teachers got to apply for a chunk of that to do things within their classrooms. We bought equipment from Minds in Motion for our special needs kids. We've actually got an eighth grade etiquette dinner coming up where we're going to have our kids go through reality store, and then they're going to dress nicely, and they're going to have a three-course meal served to them by our kitchen staff, where they basically have a manners luncheon with those community members afterwards, and part of the funding to help with that. 3D printer in the science area. We have 11 libraries, alternative seating options, geology field trip, audiobooks, a lot of other things. But we were able to allow teachers to apply for and get some things in the classroom that they've been asking for with this Title I grant. The 1-1 initiative has been a great success this year. The Dell laptops are holding up very well. my kids the opportunity to do the things they need to do to be educationally successful. Just a side note, with ISET testing coming up, based on our initial projections with the number of tests, it's going to take us 6 days to do the entire ISET on the computers. It took us 4 weeks last year to get all the kids through three computer labs. So we're going to gain back almost 3 weeks worth of instruction time. It's not going to be dedicated to testing just because we have technology to go before she moves with us. So we'll start ISET testing here at the end of February. And again, round one would have taken us a full week. Pencil paper last year, it's going to take us 2 days for the laptop, so I'm pretty excited about that. We have a program at the middle school called Gradway. We received grant funds from Cockhouse Repairs, So we have three teachers that receive a stipend, and one's at each grade level. And they actually have a group of students they meet with daily in homeroom that are what we would consider graduation risk kids. Kids who might slip through cracks, kids who may have rough home situations, school might not be a real big priority for them. So they meet on a daily basis in a small group. We do some off-campus activities with them. This year they're going to the elementary schools for a health day, did some work in classroom with kids, help custodians, did some different work there. Last year they went and helped with the mobile pack effort in Warsaw. Then we also were able to take them last year to the ropes course, I believe it was the CMA. And they were able to go through some leadership training at that ropes course. So finding opportunities for those kids that might otherwise struggle with school, trying to provide them with some options to keep them interested. Chris Martin, our art teacher, does a fantastic job of putting on an art show every year. I don't know if you guys have had an opportunity to come the last couple of years and see it. It's usually what's on in May or at the end of the school year. We have some students doing some fantastic artwork here. And she basically decorates the entire half of the commons with that work. Every kid in our school gets to display one piece. And some of them look pretty spectacular. This year, we also had the opportunity to select, I believe, three representatives from Tippecanoe Valley Middle School that will actually go to a banner contest for Fulton County, where they'll be printed on banners in, I believe, on Rochester, on the streets with our student name displaying their art. So another good opportunity for our kids in the arts curriculum. Our advanced coursework this year, we'll have some 8th graders going to high school. We'll have 6 high school credits. They'll walk out the door here. They'll get 2 credits for algebra, completing that. Middle school, they can get 2 credits for completing biology and passing the ECA. And then they're doing a blended algebra geometry class. Getting ready for advanced geometry in high school, they can receive 2 math credits for it as well. So we, just like the high schools giving kids opportunities to earn college credits, we're actually giving kids a head start here. The ability to take some early level high school courses and gain some high school credits before they move over. And then in our walkthrough, we took you down and let you look in the cage area. We used Mike and Strong money to reclaim that cage area, turn it into the weight room, and we're using that to be moved around. So that's a great addition to what we're able to offer kids here. We were also honored by the Department of Ed earlier this year for our Catch-Up Cafe. It's one of the promising practices being used in the state. Catch-Up Cafe is basically kids that don't have homework finished, they grab their lunch to go do their work in the study hall and stay caught up. So we're using that as a way to keep kids caught up. We had the day right before Christmas break, all the kids who were still on our cafe list were pulled into a room, and by the end of the day, we had 100% missing assignments turned in for kids like Christmas break. So our goal is to have that accomplished for second semester as well, to make sure all our kids are caught up and get things turned in. So it's helping us be more successful. Student activities. Our spell bowl team this year was RRC champ again. 7 of the last 8 years, Tippecanoe Valley won the spell bowl for the RRC. And this year, they also made their 3rd trip in 4 years to the state finals for small competition. So, this is C. Ross, a fantastic job getting those kids prepared. And They do very well, so it's definitely a feather in the cap for our school. Circle of State is this Saturday. We have multiple students in our choir. We went to Wabash Honeywell Center, participated with almost 100 kids. They sang in front of a packed house at Honeywell Center with kids from many other area schools. So that was a great success for them. Solo and ensemble contest just was completed here for the last 3 weeks, I believe. Andrew Burke and Mateo Salazar were world winners for our middle school. Bradley Cobble, Corey Fincher, and Ben Michael all received all three. So if you've not had a chance to see Chanel Ryder's band perform at our band performances, make sure you get that on the calendar for the spring. Because if you take into account the fact that our sixth graders walk in not even knowing how to play an instrument, and then you hear what they're able to do by the end of eighth grade, working with her, she's fantastic. And for the numbers of kids we've got here in middle school, she does an awesome job of putting on a great show with those kids. So she's definitely a highlight of what we're able to offer kids in the arts program. We were able to take our sixth graders this year to the torch relay in Fulton County, so they got to see the torch bicentennial come through Fulton County. They got to hear Mayor Ted Ed and a few others speak. And then we were able to have Fulton County wise did visit the middle school for a few days so our kids could check that out as well. It's a pretty neat experience for them. We had a voluntary Saturday trip to Manchester University and had 20 students take us up on the offer and go to tour college, get to meet professors, and maybe we had a catch football game. And we were all provided with free Manchester University shirts and information about the school. We will do an eighth grade college visit after spring break. Generally, we try to take them at least to the Ivy Tech campus in Warsaw so that they have some exposure to college campus before they go to high school. Our students completed the sock drive in October. Socktober, I believe we were over 1,000 pairs of socks that we were able to gather. And then we donated those to the families with our corporation. And I'm not sure where else did those go. I know we donated them out to students in need at the elementary school, especially right before Christmas, we gave a lot of those away. And I think we've given them to a couple of other foundations as well. But it was really cool to see our kids come together and collect all those to be able to help out. We collected over 1,400 food items for Helping Hands this year, and then our student council assisted in the distribution right before Thanksgiving at Helping Hands. And then we raised over $1,000 for community patients. That just wrapped up this week. I believe we raised just under $400 in the penny collection and right around $700 with the soccer sales. And crushes from Valentine's Day, so those will all be passed out tomorrow at the end of the day before the kids get off the bus. We had our second annual Veterans Day program here in November. Chris Martin and Sarah Thomas, both are military families, and they organized this running. We had an opportunity to come out and see this with the awesome event. The choir sings the hymns of all of the grants to the military. The band plays music. We've had the last 2 years come out and organize the finest program. Our guest speaker has been a great opportunity this year. We had an honor guard that actually did the 21 event salute. Projecting this in the gym, playing out back, so the kids were able to watch it happen here outside the gym. Our sixth graders this year were awarded an opportunity to go see Christmas Carol at the Wagon Wheel for a community grant. And we were actually provided with some very positive feedback from the Wagon Wheel people about our students, how well behaved they were, and we've been invited back for next year. So we're pretty excited about that opportunity. And then I'm very, very proud of our sixth grade team for an entire week they did an interdisciplinary unit on the movie Hidden Figures. I don't know if you've been able to see that movie or not, but it's about African-American women who were computers, were mathematicians at NASA prior to manned space flights. And so they spent the week studying civil rights, they spent the week studying mathematics, we spent a week studying NASA, and then Orpoint Center actually rented us out in private viewing of a movie for the school day, so we were watching it. It was a pretty powerful experience. We had an entire group of kids stand up and clap. Kevin Costner ripped the cover of the bathroom sign off the wall, so that was pretty cool. Our eighth graders had the formal already, this is a picture of all of them dressed up. We had 90 students attend, and that's more than we've ever had show up to our eighth grade formal, so. We decided this for the activities that normally happened in the last 2 weeks of the school year. It was just a pile of one thing after another, so we moved it up to January and actually saw our kids attend. So I'll give a great success to kids that were there. We worked really hard at middle school to try to recognize our staff and our students. Our PBS program called Viking Way, at the end of each 9 weeks, our students get to keep on a sheet. If they reach 98% attendance, they have no missing assignments and have no discipline issues. So at the end of the first quarter, I believe it was, students had the opportunity to earn a ticket into a raffle for a level rack of medallions. So these kids actually, their names were drawn, they had to ride for them all, of course, off the lunch. That was for knowledge, right? We're going to come back and actually we're doing this again here for the third quarter. We've got the names of the students who just need to get the date pinned down with the little company and they're going to come pick them up. Drive them up there again. So great way for us to celebrate the kids. We do have free athletic passes. We do front of the lunch line coupons. We've done raffles for basketballs and middle school shirts and things like that. And I all the kids who earned a coupon sheet the first 9 weeks got a ticket for the pool party night at the high school. So on Friday after school, we put the pool up. They could all go swim with our fathers over there. So try to do a lot of things that we can include that are fun for the kids that don't cost us a ton of money to be able to do. And then we started here the second 9 weeks, or second semester, I started doing the teacher of the week, having the teacher fill out some information and post that information on our Facebook site. We've done a staff recognition drawing every week for the last 2 years. This is kind of the next phase of that for us. We want to start getting the faces of our teachers and why they're teaching and what they're interested in out for our community to see. So you should see one of those each week showing up on our Facebook feed. The information about our teachers are really great things. And then very proud of last week, we were able to call to see each other week. We got some information about the Sandy Hook Promise that appeared and provided some of that information. If you look through it, we really felt like it was one of those things that was a good program, but it was sort of a negative focus. It was pretty heavy. And so we wanted to do something to celebrate our kids, and so the school improvement team and Mrs. Seabrock's, our counselor, put a lot of time and effort into kind of shifting it to a more positive week. And so we did some videos and classes during homeroom for the week about getting along, seeing each other, noticing each other. On Thursday, we kind of threw all the kids for a loop. Instead of having 6th, 7th, and 8th grade lunch, we brought a third of each grade level down for an A lunch, B lunch, and C lunch. We had our peers over here, one at each table. Some kids came out at the lunch line, they got a random table number, and they sat with a random group of people. We had teachers and parent professionals come out, sit with the kids, and high school peers ran through kids know each other activities. So they ate their lunch, they talked, they mingled. Mr. Cooper and Mrs. Simons, Mrs. Revere and myself, we bussed the tables so that they could do their activities. So it was a really great opportunity for our kids to see other kids, meet other people, talk with our high school peers. And then finished up the week with Tom Thalen, who's a national anti-bullying and student leadership speaker, coming and talking. Warsaw Breakfast Optimist Club sponsored him coming to speak to our kids. And so his main focus was teaching the kids to not be a victim. Sometimes people in the world aren't always the nicest, and you can't just be a victim. You've got to be able to stand up for yourself, stand up for your friends, and that's how we fix the world issues. So it was a really powerful week. I think it went very well. I don't know if you guys have anything to share. said, high school here was awesome, and it's good to be home, such a great job. And I've not talked to a kid that didn't have a good experience with the lunch. You know, we had a lot of them, when I met everybody on Monday, they were home on the field, there was a lot of cringing. And I know there was a lot of kids that were anxious about it, but the way it came together and it went off was fantastic, so. Highlight of some of our sports teams this year. We had 131 out of 440 kids participate in fall and winter season, so 29%, just over 29% of our middle school student body participated in sport at this point. So we got great participation for kids. It's awesome to see they're involved. Middle school football, seventh grade team was undefeated this year. This is the fourth year in a row they've been RRC champions in seventh grade. Coach has done a fantastic job teaching kids how to play the game right, play it safe, but still be competitive. And, our eighth grade finished 7-1 this year. Their only loss came to a Northfield team that I think hit puberty way before we did. Here this big. So, overall, the last 3 or 4 years, the football team's been at the top of the conference at the middle school level. Like I said, we won the seventh grade conference for 3 years. So, seen a lot of success. The 8th grade volleyball team won the Lakeview tournament this year. To our knowledge, that is the fourth time in school history volleyball team has won a tournament in the county. So we're starting to see our middle school kids become a lot more competitive in that sport. We've had a couple of conference runner-ups the last couple of years in volleyball. Now we can do a fantastic job getting the kids involved, teaching them how to play the game right, making them competitive. Our cheerleaders were Gang Festival Cheer Squad champions this summer at Gang Festival. And this is actually a picture of the competition they were able to participate in. So Catherine Scott, our cheer coach, is trying to get involved in a few more things beyond just regular cheer ball games, which is exciting. 7th grade boys basketball just won the RRC tournament this Saturday. They beat Wabash in the semifinals over time. Who was the favorite? I'm going to have Stacy talk for just a second. Stacy Revere is our academic coach, and she has been working very hard with our staff this year on data. So our collaboration time, we use Tuesday, Thursday mornings. We spend a lot of that time focusing on developing classroom data based on our standards. So I'm going to talk just a little bit about.
Basically, the power standards are coming from our PLC, our professional learning community. And basically, we're taking our Indiana State standards, which are huge, a broad amount of standards. And what we're learning is that we want to have our guaranteed curriculum. What we're going to say, 100% of our students are going to know these standards before they leave this grade level. So each one of our classes in math, English, science, and social studies have worked together to come up with these power standards. In our power standards, then we're going to be creating assessments, formative assessments, where the pre-testing kids and post-testing kids. In this, we're seeing what the kids already know. These pre-tests are showing the kids that already know the information, so they're not going to have to go back and regurgitate it all. We're going to push them and excel them to go further. We're also seeing kids that are really struggling that need a lot of extra support from those pre-tests. In these formative assessments, then when they're finished with it, they're having a post-test, and that's when the remediation piece comes in. This is, again, is our guaranteed curriculum. So that's what we've kind of been creating. We started in January. We are just starting our assessments. What's been really neat is to hear the conversations teachers are having about, hey, my kids did really bad on this. What did you do in your class? That, how did you teach the same thing? And it's been neat to hear those conversations based on data, based on information that we've learned on these kids. It's been also nice to hear them talk about going to their evaluations with Scott, and they have these data conversations, and what we can do to improve our instruction has been really neat to see.
Yeah, it's been- been a great piece to just sit down and talk to the teachers about evaluation, how it would push that look like, how are you using it, determine how you're going to continue teaching. If it's not looking good, what are you going to go back and do to fix it? If it's looking good, what are you doing to push kids, and how are you using that data to just monitor what's going on in your classroom? So this is not something I can put a spreadsheet up in front of you and show you, because it should be happening in every classroom. So it's kind of the next phase of implementing a whole PLC model of guaranteed curriculum, using formative assessments, looking at our data, and our curriculum. So we're not exactly where we want to be yet, but definitely a lot further along. We've been in this building in the past, and we're any questions? Awesome. Well, I appreciate you guys allowing us to write about our school. We've got a lot of people working really hard, a lot of kids that are definitely benefiting from the things that we've been working on over here. It's a great school, it's a great place to be. So, so we'd like to see some better data, obviously, but we're working on it.
Scott, I just have one question. On the credits, now, when those carry over to high school, I know there were some issues here a few years back, if I'm asking. For like math, if the kid's got two credits, does that mean he only has to take?
The high school rules from the state right now, depending on the diploma track, kids still have to take, and Mike, you can help me with this, they either have to take three for a core 40 or 4 years for the honors. So they'll still have to do those things to achieve, which is, I mean, we at one point in time, we were giving kids geometry credits here. We back off on that. That's why we're doing the elective math credit, because we want our top-end kids to start with geometry in the high school so that we're not outpacing what the high school has to offer. Yeah. So we still want to push them and accelerate them and give them opportunities, but we don't want to eliminate 2 years' worth of opportunities for them in high school because we push them through all that content here. So we've tried to kind of meet halfway and make it doable for the high school to be able to provide 4 years of math, but also continue to allow our kids to be accelerated here in those credits. So, yeah. And 5 years ago, your kids would have taken an algebra in the course assessment here, would have been done with it, not had to wait until they returned to sophomore in high school to take it. So, again, it's every new legislature changes the rules on us. So, it's, I don't know, we've probably got at least two different groups in high school with different graduation expectations out of the 4 years that are over there right now. So it's, my guess is that we'll just continue every year and come up with something new. We've got to do this and shift. Thank you, Mr. Pagans.
Thank you. Justin Branagh, 7th
grade girls basketball coach, TVMS. Larry DuBois, head track coach, TVMS. And Larry DuBois, eighth grade boys basketball assistant coach, TVMS. Number six, accept the resignation of the following personnel. Capri Gardner, custodian, TVHS. Number seven, approve out-of-state conference, March 9th through 11th, 2017. Number eight, approve the out-of-state conference, March 16th to 19th, 2017. Number nine, approve the overnight field trip, TVHS wrestling team. Number 10, approve out-of-state field trip, TVMS, 8th grade. Number 11, approve out-of-state overnight field trip, TVHS choir. Number 12, approve agreement with the Warsaw Area Career Center. And number 13, approve classified and administrative salaries.
Shirley Miller, middle school. Shirley is our new bank associate in the middle school.
Okay. So Shirley Miller would be the night custodian at the middle school.
Yes.
Okay. Thank you. Is there anything, fellas, that you'd like to pull off and discuss on the consent agenda?
I'll make a motion to approve the consent agenda.
Brian has made a motion to approve the consent. Do you have a second?
I'll second.
Stan seconds. All in favor of the consent agenda by signifying saying aye.
Aye.
Aye. And noes? No noes. Good on the consent agenda. On to E, the approval of claims and payroll.
Okay, thank you. We have one pre-written claim listing this evening. It's dated January 31st, 2017. The amount of $1,845,535.00. Our regular claim listing this evening is dated February 13, 2017, in the amount of $148,434.05. We have two payrolls this evening. The first is dated January 6, 2017. It's in the amount of $380,384.74. The second is dated January 20, 2017, in the amount of $335,498.40. I submit these claims for payroll for you.
Is there any questions on that? If not, do I have a motion to approve the claims and payroll is read.
I'll make that.
Brian makes that motion.
Do I have a second?
I'll second that.
Adam seconds. All in favor of the approving the claims and payroll is saying aye.
Aye.
Noes? Pass the claims and payroll. Financial report.
Okay. Have the reconciled bank statement in my monthly financial report funds for January 2017. In summary, our receipts and disbursements are total receipts for all funds $2,451,959.74. Total disbursements for all funds $2,800,359.85.
On to old business, update on the Akron Elementary School project.
And I believe Mr. Meddling is here tonight to give us an update. So, yeah, what's going on at Akron?
Hello. My adventures to me, Mr. Bug, this room right here. I remember when I built this school, this was horrible.
What?
Remember that?
Yeah.
When was the president?
Oh, boy.
So we were
kitchen area, and that seems our tile of some sort, instead of carpet. I'm glad to see this. Much easier to keep clean. Okay, on to the elementary. Now, work of progress in the last month, we continued areas of B and C on the masonry walls. Just got odds and ends to do in unit B, column wraps and things like that. They completed pouring concrete slabs, cafeteria, the office area, we did that last week. Completed the roofing, units B, C, and D. First, we go with this time. Continue with exterior brick on units B and D. And continue metal stud framing and flushing back in the unit D. And start hanging drywall in the unit D area. That's the northern wing there. And we started hanging drywall in that area also. Completed the joist and metal deck in the unit C, as well as the roof. Roof area, so that is complete there. Completed removal of required ceilings in unit A, so we can do some interior piping and some other work in there. Continued insulation and siding on the exterior walls in unit B. Probably noticed a little bit of that. Mechanical and electrical plumbing areas, we continue the HVAC piping in unit B. Continue overhead ductwork in C and D. Continue wall rough ends, units C and D. Continue fire protection piping in unit C and D. Continue work in the boiler room and mechanical room. That's a lot of piping that goes in that boiler room there. It spreads throughout the building. In the next 4 weeks, we'll start this week installing exterior windows. I went was on the east side of the gym, but they go in also. Continue with exterior brick around the unit B. Start exterior of the precast concrete panels on the office area. We started that today, got the panels out. Take metal stud framing in unit D. Interior masonry in unit B. Continue drywall in unit D. Continue exterior metal panel up in the unit B area. And we're going to start painting. Probably have a meeting this week with the painters, electricians, in some areas before you move on. The mechanical and electrical, continue working in the boiler room and mechanical room. Continue piping in C and D, continue wall and overhead electrical roof ends, continue mechanical plumbing insulation, and temporary heat deck. Here's this is the area right here for the actually C on the plan, but it'll be designated as unit D when we're done. Some framing that's going on. And kind of right there, that is the office area. That's the stone you see there, ready for concrete. And there's now that board, I think it was 30 before that. That's all part of this time. And there's another picture, that's the hallway from the office area going back into the classroom area. Right there we see the kind of back windows. That was the courtyard area between the old building and the northern part of the building.
that is the cafeteria area. The other again on the right is the windows there, that's right, that's the courtroom area. I'm sorry, yeah, courtroom. Courtyard area, I'm just right here. So it might be a room someday. And this is material that will be used for extra piping and some steel framing and that has to go. And the future side here, new to be where we had that section on over there after the building store down.
So that's the east side of the new wing?
Yes, that's the side that, yeah, east side of the new wing. The rack goes on the south side of the new wing. This area right here, that's where it says east side. Yeah, that's on the east side of the community area.
That gives us a good idea of what we're pulling stuff on.
Yeah.
There's a portion.
And I think the next slide there would be the, some of the same area. There's the siding that you see on the north side of Unit B. That's all of Unit B, and that area to the right is the kitchen area right behind it. And then where you see the opening there, that's the mezzanine above the boiler room where my equipment goes up there. And here on the, this is the boiler room area where a lot of the pipings going in for the, those are hooked to the circulating pumps. Those go to the different areas. You can see them right here in that picture. And that is, that's a, our side here, you'd be resident area. As far as your schedule goes, is there any questions on this concern here? As our schedule goes, we're still roughly in the 2 week behind area on the external, most initially we're inside, we're moving right along, we don't get inside that area. There's a lot of music there. Anybody wants to talk to, let me know, and we'll reach you soon.
Maybe with the warm weather, we need to, any change in that?
This is great.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, this is great. They're putting some masonry work on the outside, they're working on that. We want to get some of the inside masonry completed so we can move along a little better on the inside.
Jim said they started putting some of the precast up today.
Yeah.
How do they fast it?
That's over fast to the masonry wall. There's a bracket, some sort of goes in slots on the panels. And that's what we did with the masonry wall. And it sets on, start at the bottom, drill holes in concrete, footing. And set those panels in there with on top of a pin on the whole road and concrete and panels.
So there was no mortar involved in that?
Yes.
There is.
It's a bed of mortar.
Okay.
At the bottom of those panels have a slot in. That's some probably 3/4 of an inch wide, about that deep. And use the mortar tie in those.
So can they do that without heating it?
Yeah, well, okay. This time of year, or this weather, you can.
Yeah. Okay.
They're still heating sand and water, you know, formation for it. And so that kind of speeds up setting. It's moving along pretty good. You just got a couple guys, about 3 or 4 of them work on the panels on the outside. And when you set one
Sundays to get us back up to date, or maybe, or...
Well, we're hoping that. We have improved on the inside, you know, that's what we've got to have, and inside out, so. And Mason's have been working about every Saturday, not the whole crew, but, you know, getting shafts set up, so they can continue moving on. And we worked last Saturday, we started the limestone panels on the outside, so they can move on that today. And then some other work on the inside, and just layouts of the crew when they come in this morning, they start on that work. Got one guy that likes to do all the layout work, and that's a good job of layout. But actually, the first course down, and we're really established. And then the Mason's come in, and put the work, and move along, so.
You said, Jim, they're gonna start some painting, do some painting?
Well, Brandon wanted to meet with the painter this week. I can't see that happening yet because of the moisture, but we'll see what he said about it. We want to wash, to have moisture in that room.
So any questions for Jim? Jim, it's exciting to see the progress.
Thank you.
On the old business, on to H, new business, approved revision to school board policy on Sunday and Wednesday observances.
Yeah, I'll give you guys a part of copy
of the board report,
and also the revisions policy. In essence, it's the policy on Sunday, it's the observances. The following statement in item number two of the policy has been deleted. And that's the statement that says, any other school activity held between the hours of 1 and 5 p.m. on Sunday must have prior approval. And that has been deleted. Everything else in the policy that has remains the same. I believe, based on our prior discussions, that that's what I bring you to you tonight.
Any other discussions about it, or are we all okay? Do we have a motion to approve? Stan makes a motion to approve. Second. Second. All in favor of the revisions for the Sunday and Wednesday observations, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Approve there. Number two, approve the following Gasco Endowment Youth Services Keys Grants. We've got a few of them here. Andrea Michael, TVSC Media Specialist. It's a visit by author, Paige Rowell, $1,250. Stacy Revere, TVMS and TVHS. Instructional coach, books for level library, $2,575. Julie Baxter, Akron Elementary, bass xylophone bars, $419. Deb Miller, Akron Elementary, materials and charter education for $203. Kayla Razzie, Akron Elementary, materials for character education, supplies and materials for choice play, $275. Alisa Beachy, Mentone Elementary, flexible classroom seating, $109. Kim Iser, Mentone Elementary, Herd of Observation Area for first grade, $200. Jenny Shear, Mentone Elementary, books for level library, $750. Aaron Eastgate, TVHS graphic calculators for math instruction, $1,000. And Shelley Engel, TVHS nonfiction and fiction books for independent reading, $407. Do I have a motion to accept these Keys grants? Eric makes that motion, second.
I'll second that.
Alan seconds that. All in favor of accepting the Keys grants, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Grants are accepted. Approved Comprehensive Counseling Initiative Planning Grant.
If you remember at the last board meeting, Mr. Lady and she also was with here, this is John McCaw, and this is Brett Bob, and presentation about the Lilly Endowment Comprehensive Counseling Initiative Planning Grant. And at that point in time, they were expecting to hear something very soon. I think they were thinking about the next day. So what we're doing is bringing that to you tonight for approval. Just as a reminder, they were recently awarded a planning grant of $30,000 to the Valley School Corporation for our comprehensive counseling initiative. As part of that planning process, we have a committee of staff members from all our schools. As part of the planning process, we will have a committee of staff members from all of our schools. We're going to spend the next 3 months analyzing data, looking at our current counseling programs, identifying best practices, visiting programs, engaging community partners, and several other activities. In fact, tonight you approved a couple of out-state conferences for people to attend conferences for this initiative. After the planning and study phases, we will then submit an implementation grant proposal to fund those strategies developed by the committee to move us closer to a comprehensive counseling model addresses the academic, college, career, and social-emotional needs of our K-12 students. Those implementation grants will be competitive, and proposals are due to be submitted by May 19, 2017. So my recommendation tonight is for to approve that planning grant. I don't know, Aaron, is there anything else you want to share with the board about that and where we're headed?
The first committee meeting is going to be at this week. That's for the schools with us. That's where we're sharing ideas.
That's going to be a big task. So we just need approval of the planning grant.
I'll make that motion. Motion, Brian makes that motion. Approve the planning grant, second. Stan seconds. All in favor of the planning grant, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Nays. It's approved. Approval of new course at TEHS, the PLTW Biomedical Science.
Project lead. Excited to bring that to the high school. Dr. Bennett, since you're tonight.
Thank you, folks. We are looking to bring in class to high school project leading by biomedical. This class will push students to take on real world challenges that they are likely to face in the biomedical science profession. They're going to engage in compelling hands-on activities, and we are looking to generate interest and cooperation with regional hospitals and the orthopedic industry in Warsaw to help us fund this and do those kinds of things. It will fulfill graduation requirements. We are looking to offer the first two classes on site, which would be principles of biomedical science and human body systems on site, and then the two more advanced classes we would offer at Warsaw High School through the vocational program. Cost analysis at this point, starting cost would be approximately $17,000 for the program starting. We have been working with the Warsaw Area Career Center and generated $11,000 from them. We are working with the Solidia on generating the remaining $6,000. We're we're optimistic that we can do that. If we cannot generate that through grant funding, we can try to look at funding that in other capacity. This continues with what we're trying to do with high school, is offer a wide range of courses, meet the demands that our students have. Project Leadability is the way to do that. Last year we started some new computer classes, Mr. Parker's class. We've had Project Leadability classes, Mr. Heidel's class. This is the latest thing in the science world. And we feel that this would be very good additions to our course.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. I have a motion to accept these two courses. Make that motion, Pat. And I'll make some motion, second. All in favor of adding the new courses to the high school, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
You are accepted. About from our high school representative, what's going on over at the high school?
Okay. Recently, in the past couple weeks, we've had two half days to raise money for the Children's Hospital, and we've been successful in both attempts with that. A lot of student involvement, not only because they want to wear the hats and the other guys as the great rules, right, but also to help out other cause. Our spring sports are starting up now. We have baseball, softball, and all that stuff is getting around. Definitely seeing students getting excited about that. And like Mr. Bragg said earlier in his presentation, I'm pretty sure you got to come to the middle school and help out with the community. And I just wanted to thank you personally for giving us the opportunity to do that. It was a great time to come over here and get to know your kids. And see those cliques that we all see form at such a young age dissolve as they got to know each other more personally. Looking to the future, I can definitely say that our seniors are looking forward to the PC trip. Quite a few of us over this year. I think it will be a great experience along with our trip. Thank you. That's some of the stuff that's going on. And,
do you know how many signed up for DC and SHIP?
I don't know. I just have a lot.
Good. That's an awesome trip. That's worthwhile. You might never make it there again, so worthwhile getting out there. Well, I believe that's the end of the session. This meeting is the Valley School Corporation's adjourned. Thank you for coming.